हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सेंट सेबास्टियन प्री यूनिवर्सिटी कॉलेज। दिस वीडियो ऑन कंटिन्यूशन ऑफ चैप्टर 2 यूनिट्स एंड मेजरमेंट्स। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी स्टडीड अबाउट सिग्निफिकेंट फिगर्स एंड राउंडिंग ऑफ। इन टुडेज क्लास लेट अस स्टडी अबाउट डायमेंशंस, डायमेंशनल फॉर्मूला and dimensional equations and dimensional analysis. Now let us quickly revise the last class, that is significant figures. The reported result of measurement is a number that includes all digits in the number that are known are reliably plus the first digit that is uncertain. The reliable digit plus the first uncertain digits are known as significant digits or significant figures. The rules for determining the number of significant figures. The first one, all the non-zero digits are significant. Second one, all the zeros between two non-zero digits are significant, no matter where the decimal point is. If at all. Third one, if the number is less than 1, the zeros on the right of the decimal point but to the left of first non-zero digits are not significant. Fourth one, the terminal or trailing zero in a number without a decimal point are not significant. Fifth one, the trailing zeros in a number with a decimal point are significant. These are the rules for determining the number of significant figures. Rounding off the uncertain digits. Rounding off a number means a dropping of digits which are not significant. The following rules are followed for a rounding of the numbers. First one, if the digits to be dropped are greater than 5, then add 1 to the preceding significant figure. If the digit to be dropped is less than 5, then it is dropped without bringing any change in the preceding significant figures. Third one, if the digit to be dropped is 5, then preceding digit will be left unchanged. If the preceding digit is even, and it will be increased by 1. If it is odd. Fourth one, in any involved or complex multi-step calculation, one should retain in intermediate steps one digit more than the significant digits and rounded off to a proper significant figures at the end of the calculation. These are the things we studied in the previous video. In today's class, let us study about dimensions of physical quantity. The nature of physical quantity is described by its dimensions. All the physical quantities can be expressed in terms of the 7 base or fundamental quantities, like mass, length, time, electric current, thermodynamic temperature, intensity of light and amount of substance, rise to some power. The dimensions of a physical quantity are the powers to which the fundamental or base quantities are rise to represent that quantity. The dimensions of physical quantity are the powers to which the base quantities are rise to represent that quantity. So here we call these base quantities are 7 dimensions of a physical world, which are denoted with a square bracket. Square bracket is a representation of dimensions. Now, the dimensions of a physical quantity are the powers to which the fundamental quantities are rise to represent that quantity. That is called dimensions of a physical quantity. It is represented by a square bracket. Examples: the dimensions of volume of an object are L to the power cube. It is represented in the dimensional formula, that is square bracket L to the power cube. The dimension of the force are mLt to the power minus 2. The dimensions of energy are mL to the power square t to the power minus 2. These are the some of the example for a dimensions. Dimensional quantity. The dimensional quantity is a physical quantity which has dimensions. So some of the physical quantities having a dimensions, so it is called as a dimensional quantity. For example, speed, acceleration, momentum, torque, etc. Dimensionless quantity. Some of the physical quantity does not have any dimensions, then it is called a dimensionless quantity. A dimensionless quantity is a physical quantity which has no dimensions. For example, relative density, refractive index, strain, etc. Dimensional constant. Some of the constant which is having a dimensions. A dimensional constant is a constant which has a dimensions. For example, universal gravitational constant, Planck's constant, etc. A dimensionless constant. The dimensionless constant is a constant which has no dimensions. For example, pi, the value of E, etc. Those are a dimensionless constant. So here, what do you mean by dimensional quantity? A dimensional quantity is a physical quantity which has dimensions. Dimensionless quantity means it is a physical quantity which has no dimensions. Dimensional constant means it is a constant which has dimensions. Dimensionless constant means the constant which has no dimensions. Now let us see the dimensional formulae and dimensional equations. Now, the expression which shows how and which of the base quantities represent the dimensions of a physical quantity is called dimensional formula of the given physical quantity. Dimensional formulae and dimensional equations. Now, what do you mean by dimensional formula? That is, our physical quantities are expressed by the base quantities. That is called a dimensional formula. For example, dimensional formula for volume is m L to the power cube t. Dimensional formula of speed, m to the power 0, L to the power 1, t to the power minus 1. Dimensional formula of acceleration is m to the power 0, L, t to the power minus 2. So, here, or else we can give an example for a density. Density means mass by volume. Mass is having the dimension m, volume is having the dimension l cube. So it is m l to the power minus 3. So for the dimensional equation, an equation is obtained by equating a physical quantity with its dimensional formula. Is called a dimensional equation of a physical quantity. So you are getting an equation by equating a physical quantity with its dimensional formula. By using the dimensional formula, you are getting some equation that is called a physical quantity, is called a dimensional equations. The dimensional value for velocity m to the power 0, l to the power 3, t to the power 0. Acceleration, dimensional expression for a acceleration m to the power 0, l to the power 1, t to the power minus 2. Now let us see the dimensional analysis and its applications. Dimensional analysis is a tool to find or check the relations among physical quantities by using their dimensions. When magnitude of two or more physical quantities are multiplied, their units should be treated in the same manner as ordinary algebraic symbols. We can cancel identical units in the numerator and denominator. Similarly, physical quantities represented by symbols on both the sides of a mathematical equation must have the same dimensions. And we have the dimensional analysis can be used to check the dimensional consistency of equations by using principle of homogeneity of dimensions. Second one, to convert units in one system into another system, to derive the relation between physical quantities based on certain reasonable assumptions. Let us see the first application of dimensional analysis, that is conversion of the unit of physical quantity from one system into another system. Now, the unit of force is dyne in CGS system and Newton in MK system. So both are unit for a force, the dyne as well as Newton. Both are unit for a force in a different system, that is CGS system and MK system. The dimensional formula for force is m l t to the power minus 2. Let the unit of length, mass and time be, we are considered as L1, M1 and T in CGS system. Similarly, the unit of length, mass and time in MK system we are considered as L2, M2 and T. Here, in all the system, the time is considered in time is having the unit is second. So in both the case, we are considered T only. Only we are changing L length and mass. The length and mass, both the system, it is represented by different way. So we are considered as L1, L2, M1 and M2. So 1 Newton divided by 1 time, that is equal to substitute M2 L2 t to the power minus 2. We have to write in terms of their dimensional formula, that is M L t to the power minus 2. In that order we have to write. Similarly, 1 time is equal to M M1 L1 t to the power minus 2. Now we will write the mass terms together, M2 divided by M1, L2 by L1, that is equal to t^-2 divided by t^-2, they will be get cancel out. So that is equal to mass is represented in the MK system as a kilogram. So m^2, that is mass in a MK system, that is 1 kilogram. Length in a MK system is represented by 1 meter. Whereas in the CGS system, mass is represented by 1 gram and length is represented in 1 centimeter. So we can write 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram divided by 1 gram. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter divided by 1 centimeter. So the gram get cancelled, centimeter get cancelled, we will get 10^5. So LHS 1 Newton is equal to RHS 10^5 dyne. Similarly, you can prove 1 joule is equal to 10^7 arc. Students, you try to solve that 1 joule is equal to 10^7 arc. Okay, so here the main intention means we can convert the physical quantity of one unit into another unit. So one system into another system, one unit into another system. Let us see the second application of dimensional analysis, that is checking the correctness of an equation. Now let us study about the checking the correctness of equation by using the principle of homogeneity. That means we have to prove that the left hand side is equal to right hand side. Consider an equation S is equal to ut plus half at square, where s is the displacement, u is the initial velocity, a is the uniform acceleration, and t is the time interval. Now writing the dimensions of each term, we have to represent s is the displacement. Write the dimensional formula for s is equal to, displacement is represented by length. So it is S is equal to, dimensional formula of displacement is L. U is the initial velocity. For a initial velocity, we can write the velocity means distance by time. That is L t^-1. U T. So one more T is there. That is for a dimensional formula is T. That comes L T divided by T. So T get cancelled. You are having the expression is L. Whereas one more term, that is A t^-2. A means acceleration. Acceleration, we can write L t^-2, that into T square, that is t^ square. So t^ square divided by t^-2 square, it will be get cancelled. So you are getting L. Since every term in the equation has the same dimension, the equation is dimensionally correct. In the left hand side is equal to right hand side. So all the terms, the dimension is same. So it is the left hand side is equal to right hand side. That is the principle of homogeneity. Each terms on the right hand side of this equation has the dimensions of length, which is same as the dimension of left hand side of the equation. Hence, this equation is dimensionally correct equation. If an equation is not dimensionally correct, then it must be a wrong equation. But dimensionally correct equation need not be an exact equation. Okay, this you have to note it down. The dimensionally correct equation need not be an exact equation. Equation is not dimensionally correct, it must be a wrong equation. That is how checking the correctness of equation. Now students, in the similar way you have to prove the equation V is equal to U plus AS. You have to check whether the equation is dimensionally correct or not. V is the initial final velocity, U is the initial velocity, A is the acceleration and S is the displacement. I will repeat again. V is the final velocity, U is the initial velocity, A is the acceleration and S is the displacement. Try for this equation. The third one, deriving a correct relationship between different physical quantity. We have to deducing the relation among a physical quantities. Consider a simple pendulum of length L. The period of pendulum may be, so the period of pendulum, it depends on mass M, length L, also the acceleration due to gravity G. The period of oscillation T be the proportional to m to the power x, l to the power y and g to the power z. In equation we can write the period of oscillation is proportional to m to the power x, l to the power y and g to the power z. That proportionality we will take some constant. The constant is k. Now write the dimensions. Dimension T, that is equal to dimensional m to the power x, dimensional l to the power y, dimensional l t to the power minus 2 to the power z. So we have to write the dimensional equation for a time, that is t, mass m, length capital L, acceleration due to gravity L t to the power minus 2. Now here in a left hand side m to the power 0, L to the power 0, t to the power is 1, whereas in the left hand right hand side m to the power x we have L, we can write L to the power y plus z. We have to add both the terms, L the power y plus z, then t to the power minus 2 z. Equating the dimensions of m, l and t on both the sides we get. Now we have to compare the dimensional values from the left hand side and right hand side. Okay, you have to compare both the side their dimensional values. So here in the right hand side x is there, in the left hand side for m to the power is 0, that we have to take x is equal to 0. Similarly y plus z, that is the power of L in the right hand side, y plus z, in the left hand side L to the power is 0, so we can write y plus z is equal to 0. Similarly we can write for a t to the power minus 2z. Minus 2z is equal to, in the left hand side the power is 1. Solving these equations we get x is equal to 0, y is equal to half and z is equal to minus half. So once you got the value of z, z is equal to minus half, substitute in, that is in the middle equation, that is y plus z is equal to 0, where z value is minus half, so you will get y is equal to half. Now in equation, the first equation, that t is equal to k m to the power x l to the power y g to the power z, in that equation you have to put the value of, that is x is equal to 0 and y is equal to half and z is equal to minus half. That power value you have to substitute. So t is equal to k times l to the power half g to the power minus half, where x to the power is 0, so m to the power 0. So you will get k is equal to square root of l by g. The value of k can be found out experimentally and it comes out 2 pi. Thus, the required relation is t is equal to, the value of k is 2 pi, substitute. So t is equal to 2 pi square root of l by g. That is the equation of period of oscillation of simple pendulum. So we have a three dimensional applications. One is the conversion of the unit of physical quantity from one system into another. Second one, the checking the correctness of an equation. Third one, deriving a correct relationship between different physical quantities. These are the three applications of a dimensional analysis. So the dimensional of physical quantity, any quantity is represented by its space quantities, isn't it? Now let us see the limitations of dimensional analysis. The first one, the value of the dimensionless constant is proportionality cannot be determined by the method of dimensions. It has to be determined by the experiments only. So these are the limitations I am telling. The limitations of dimensional analysis is, the first one, the value of the dimensionless constant of proportionality cannot be determined by the method of dimensions. It has to be determined only by the experiment. In the last slide you observed, isn't it, that is the value of k. So k value we cannot find through a dimensional analysis. It is the value of k we got only through the experiments. Okay, that is the first limitations. Second one, the use of dimensional analysis is restricted to a physical relationship which are power functions and cannot be used for a relationship involving exponential and trigonometric functions. We cannot use this dimensional analysis for a trigonometric value, even exponential values. Third one, if the number of quantities on which a physical quantity depends exceeds the number of fundamental units involved, it is not possible to obtain an expression relating them. So if the number is, physical quantity number is exceeds, you have 4 or 5 number of physical quantity, then it is very difficult to express in terms of dimensions more than 5. Okay, that is the third one. It can check only whether a physical relation is a dimensionally correct or not. So that is what we observed in the second one, checking the correctness of an equation. We can check whether the equation is correct or not, but it cannot tell whether the relation is absolutely correct or not. That is what I said. The dimensionally Incorrect equation, always incorrect. Dimensionally correct equation, not always a correct equations. These are the four limitations of dimensional analysis. So we studied about dimensional of physical quantity, dimensional formula and dimensional equations and dimensional analysis and its applications and limitations of dimensional analysis. So here we come to the end of the second lesson, that is units and measurements. Thank you, dear students.